Hello and welcome in our YouTube channel Metallurgical Facts. So this is part 10th of this video series, and we are doing metallurgical engineering question practice in this video series. So this video series is basically for GATE Metallurgy GATE 2021 practice for practice purpose. Okay, so if you find any problem in this video series or in any question of GATE Metallurgy, you may directly send us on our Instagram page. We will try to include those questions in our upcoming videos. Okay, and also I hope that this video series will be very beneficial for your GATE preparation and for your revision purpose. Okay, so now we will do the question. So the first question is that a mixed dislocation can be categorized by one of the following. So the first option is the angle between the dislocation line and its bezel vector is zero. So this B part is the angle between the dislocation line and its bezel vector is 45, and the angle between the dislocation line and bezel vector is 90 degree, and D part is any of the above. Okay, so this question is not this option is not correct, that is any of the above, because the angle between the dislocation line and its bezel vector is zero when this this is screw dislocation case. Okay, so this is basically screw dislocation. Also we can say that this dislocation line and bezel vector is parallel. Okay, so this dislocation line is parallel to this bezel vector, then this is screw dislocation case. So this option is also not correct. So C option is the angle between the dislocation line and its bezel vector is 90 degree, means perpendicular case. Okay, so this is the perpendicular case, so we can say that this is edge dislocation basically. Okay, so this is the example of edge dislocation. Next option is B part, that is angle between this dislocation line and bezel vector is 45. Okay, so in many of the material, dislocation are found where the dislocation line and bezel vector are neither perpendicular or nor parallel, but these dislocations are in that case these dislocations are called as mixed dislocation. Okay, so when the case where there will be no not parallel or not perpendicular case, so that will known as mixed dislocation, and sometimes that have angle of 45 degree. Okay, so this B part is correct here. So B part is correct answer for this question. So the next question is, what is the theoretical requirement of air in meter cube at STP, that is standard temperature and pressure, for the complete combustion of 100 meter cube of a fuel consisting of pure CH4, means this fuel, this 100% pure fuel contains this CH4. Okay, so assuming that air contains 20 volume percent of oxygen, we need to find the theoretical requirement of air. So how to combust this CH4? So CH4 will be combust like that, CH4 plus O2, and this will produce carbon dioxide and H2 gases. Okay, so CH4, and if we will balance this equation, okay, so this if we will balance this equation, this will balance like that. Okay, so for combusting one mole of for the combustion of this CH4, for one mole of CH4 we need two mole of this oxygen. Okay, so number of mole required for combustion of one mole of CH4 is equals to 2 mole of oxygen. Okay, so now we can find theoretical amount of air required. So how we can find this theoretical amount of air required? That is, we are having 100% of air, and in that 100% of air, we have 21 volume percent of oxygen, and we also know the number of moles of oxygen. Okay, so this is the formula. So 100 by 21, and number of moles of oxygen required for the combustion of one mole of CH4 is 2 moles. Okay, so by that way we can find 9.52 meter cube. Okay, so this is for one meter cube or one mole of CH4. Suppose if we need to find for 100 meter cube of fuel, so we need to multiply this value by 100. So 9.52 by 100 is equals to 952 meter cube of oxygen is required at STP for that much CH4. Okay, so this 952 is correct answer for this question. So the next question is, which one of the following NDT techniques cannot be used to detect an internal crack in an steel shaft. In a steel shaft. Okay, so four options are liquid penetration inspection, radiography, ultrasonic testing, and X-ray tomography. Okay, so the basic fundamental of this NDT is that there are few NDT techniques which cannot be used for internal cracks. Okay, so for surface crack, for identifying of surface crack, we need visual inspection. We can do the visual inspection. So these all are NDT types. Okay, so visual inspection, liquid penetration test. Okay, in general, liquid inspection, liquid penetrant inspection. Okay, so this is also a type of NDT which may be used for finding the surface crack. Okay, and the other one is magnetic particle inspection. Okay, so these three may be used for surface, only for surface crack, and for internal crack we can use many NDT techniques like radiography. Okay, so radiography, other one is ultrasonic testing, the next one is eddy current testing. Okay, and also acoustic emission test. So these all are the NDT techniques which may be used for internal cracking. Okay, so X-ray tomography is also one of the part of this for finding the internal cracking by the NDT method. Okay, so these three may be used for surface cracking, and these all may be used for internal cracking. I hope you understood this concept. So from here we can find that this radiography, ultrasonic testing, and X-ray tomography is wrong, because these are used for internal cracks. Okay, and this is only the option which is used for surface cracks. So A option is correct here. So the next question is matching type of question. So here, match the defect listed in group first. So these are the defects listed in group first with the process listed in group second. Okay, so these are the defects, and these are the some forming processes and some welding processes also there. Okay, so for matching type of questions, you may write like that P, Q, R, S, and you can find one by one. Okay, so here I will tell you the list of the defects of these processes, and also I will supply the PDF file of these defects list in metal forming process, in metal casting, and in welding processes. Okay, so please try to remember these defects, please try to learn these defects. Okay, so for rolling edge cracking, so these are the defects of rolling. So edge cracking, wavy edge, so these are the important defects of this forming processes. Okay, so alligatoring is also a defect of rolling processes. Okay, and the other one is zipper crack, so this is very important crack. Okay, and important defect of this rolling. Okay, so here we can find that rolling we can match through this alligatoring, so R we can match by one. Okay, so the next thing is that forging. Okay, so forging defects are here. So the first one is blowhole is a forging effect, buckling, or this is also known as lap formation. And the other one is cracking at flash. Okay, so this is also a rolling defect, this is also a forging defect. Hot shortness is also due to this forging, and this happens in this forging processes. Okay, so other defects are cold set, or also known as fold. Okay, so these are the defects under this forging processes. So here cold set is here, so we can match this cold set through this forging. So P we can match by 2. Okay, now we are having earing effect. So earing is basically a unique effect which happens in this deep drawing process. Okay, so this happens, this occurs in always in pairing. Okay, and this is earing effect. So this earing effect we can match through this deep drawing process. So Q we can match by 3. So what is shrinkage porosities? This shrinkage porosity is basically a defect in welding process, most commonly in fusion welding process. Okay, so what are the defects in welding processes? I am writing here most important defects are undercut, slag inclusion. Slag inclusion is also a type of defect in this welding process, and the other one is excess penetration, and the last one is porosity. Okay, so these are some defects here I have listed like in this question they asked for only rolling, forging and deep drawing and fusion welding. So that's why I have mentioned only these three. Okay, but in PDF file you will get defects of every forming process, every casting process and of welding process. So if you did not join our Telegram channel, you may join so that we can supply our PDF file there, and you may remember these defects, you may list those defects there. Okay, and also the products of the forming processes I will give in that PDF. Okay, so S we can match by 4, so we are having code of 2 3 1 4. Okay, so options which is starting other than 2 we can cross, so D option is wrong. Okay, so here we can match options 2 3, so this B part is also incorrect, A part is also incorrect, and C part is correct here. Okay, so C is correct answer for this question, and this is the way of doing matching questions in exam also. Okay, so that you can avoid the silly mistakes in exam. So the next question is aluminium powder having apparent density. So apparent density of aluminium powder is given, that is AD. Apparent density is given, that is 810 kilograms per meter cube. Okay, is compacted in a cylindrical die at 600 MPa. So this is pressure. Okay, so the density of as pressed aluminium compact is 1755 kilogram per meter cube. So compacted density is also given, that is CD. We can assume CD, that is 1755 kilograms per meter cube. If the height of as pressed compact is given, so as pressed compact height is given, that is H2 is given here 12 mm. So we need to find the fill height. Okay, so what is the fill height we need to find? So this is basically a initial height. Okay, so we can also find this question through a formula which is applicable for this the apparent density and compacted density and sintered density. But here I will tell you the easy way, that is easy calculation. Okay, so what we are having formula like that, density is equals to mass by volume. Okay, so here in this case density is apparent density and this is compact density, so we will find through these two equations. Okay, so here density is equals to mass, so I will write like that, A density for apparent density, this is AD is equals to mass by volume. Volume we can find like that, area multiplied by this height, this fill height. Okay, so this is H1. So this is our equation first, and the equation second is CD is equals to M. CD is compacted density, CD is equals to M by A. So M, you can write like that, M2 M1 A1 A2. Okay, and into H2. Okay, so this is the second equation, but here this is sintering case, so we can assume that mass will be the constant every time, mass and area will be constant. So we can sort this equation like that, AD by CD, or AD by CD is equals to H2 by H1. Okay, like that. So now we need to put the values like that, 810 and 1755 is given here, is equals to H2 we are having 12, and H1 we need to find. So H1 will be equals to 12 into 1755 by 810. Okay, so from here we will get H2 26 mm. Okay, so this is the correct answer, and this is the simple formula you can utilize, you can use for the you can use for finding the initial height or the as pressed or the fill height, initial fill height. Okay, so this is the simple formula, you can use this concept, and you can find the question. You need not to apply any powder metallurgy formula for this type of questions, and also I have already provided the formula which is applicable for powder metallurgy, which is for finding the apparent density, porosity and sintered density in our previous video. Okay, so you may go through that video, that sieve analysis video, and you can find the formula there. Okay, so the correct answer is 26 mm. Thank you guys for your attention, hope you have understood these concept, hope you have understood these questions, and also we will come with some more questions in our upcoming videos. Please have some patience because I have already many works to do. So in between these works I will try to upload more and more videos as much as I can do before the GATE exam. So please try to focus on your studies and try to prepare for GATE exam, which is after 1 month. Okay, so thank you, and subscribe our channel, press bell icon for getting notification. Thank you.